guys, welcome to this new Arabic lesson with me, Maha. No time, no see, because I've been concentrating for the past month on my online Arabic courses. I think you know that when this whole crisis of the coronavirus started, I had to cancel two of my courses on the Holy Land and to refund all the students and to tell them, I'm sorry, I can't hold the courses, we can't travel. So I came up with the idea of having the lessons or the courses online, and that's what happened, and that's why I've been absent from you. But I, as you can see, still didn't forget you, and I'm going to do one new lesson for you today. The lesson of today is going to be in the Palestinian dialect, or the Shami Levantine dialect in general, which is a dialect spoken in Palestine, Syria, Lebanon, and Jordan. Today's lesson was taught in one of my lessons this morning. The students asked me something super important, which is how to say shame on you, how to feel embarrassed, how to say I'm shy, I'm ashamed of, using the verb, using the adjective of that, and also a very popular word that I'm going to teach you that I told them this morning that is used in every Arab household. You will hear this one word, which has a connection with being ashamed or feeling ashamed or something that's forbidden to do. Let's discover these words in this lesson. Let's get started. So I want you to remember that today's lesson is in Palestinian Arabic or Shami Arabic in general, and this is not the correct standard Arabic or the real classical Arabic. No, this is a more approach, a closer approach to the spoken language, the language that is spoken by this particular people coming from Syria, Lebanon, and Jordan, and Palestine, but very widely spread and widely understood by the majority of Arabs, because we in Arabic, we speak the spoken Arabic, not the standard Arabic. All right, so let's get started. I started the lesson today by using the verb istaha. I'm gonna write it here. I hope this is my whiteboard. So let's look at this verb. I will write everything in Latin letters for you so you don't end up killing yourselves. Istaha. That's a past tense verb, by the way, and it's a very difficult verb because it's derived, because it has more than three normal letters, and it has also two vowels. This istaha, it means he was ashamed. He was ashamed, he felt ashamed, he felt embarrassed. So istaha, to feel ashamed or to feel some kind of embarrassment. Now this is a past tense verb, so it can be conjugated with a lot of pronouns. In standard Arabic we have 12 pronouns. I was ashamed, he was ashamed, they too. In a Palestinian Arabic, we only have 7 ways to say I, you, they, we, he, she, and that's it. We don't have other pronouns. So very similar to the English one without a lot of complexity. So istaha, he felt ashamed. That's in the past tense. Istaha. Now if she felt ashamed, we can say ista. Hat. I promised to write it in Latin letters. So istaha. Try to work on your istaha. He felt ashamed. Istaha. While she felt ashamed. Istahat. 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 Remember, if you are concentrating a lot about how words are created in Arabic, what you noticed here is that the alif maksura gets removed totally in the conjugation when I have to add a different suffix of the conjugation. So istaha doesn't become istahat, no, it becomes istahat. I can conjugate all of the verb istaha to you, but that's not the reason I'm doing this course, this lesson today, not verb conjugation, but how to use these in the daily life or in situational Arabic situations. So let's look at he was ashamed or he felt embarrassed. Istaha. Now this istaha or she istahat is not to feel ashamed of something you have done wrong. No, don't get me wrong. Istaha, we use it when you are embarrassed, okay? And istahat, just like simply embarrassed, not because you've done something wrong. This is one of the verbs. Istaha, to feel embarrassed or to feel ashamed. From this istaha, we take the imperative verb, shame on you. That's when we use you have to be ashamed or to have to be embarrassed because you did something wrong. So why did I start the lesson by just the verb simple feeling embarrassed? the verb to be embarrassed, because it's a verb, not an adjective, because I wanted to come to this point where we use it not in order to say you have to feel embarrassed by yourself, no, but to feel, to say you have to be ashamed of yourself. To be ashamed of yourself, بالعربي, we use it for taken from this verb, and that's why I started by teaching you the slight simple verb. Now let's see if my verb is istaha, be ashamed or feel ashamed or shame on you. This is the verb. Istahi. So you see, it's very, very similar to the verb. Istaha, istahi. It's an imperative verb. Istahi. If you're a female, it ends with a longer E. Istahi. Istahi. You feel ashamed. Shame on you. And istahi. Shame on you, female. And istahu, all of you, shame on you. Now this enough, it means shame on you. Why? Because again, we're using the verb, imperative verb, out of the normal verb to be ashamed or to be embarrassed. And I'm telling you, be embarrassed with yourself. Now, you can stop this thing, just like say, feel ashamed of yourself or shame on you by stopping at istahu. Or you can make it a little bit more, like stronger and a little bit more emphasized by adding, you will see what I'm going to add. Istahi ala halak. So we're not stopping at istahi, we are saying istahi ala, both are fine because we're speaking Palestinian Arabic. Halak. What is this? What is this? Istahi ala halak. Let's look at it one more time. Istahi ala halak. I'm not telling you only istahi, but istahi ala halak. Let me move here. Istahi ala halak. It literally means istahi, be ashamed or feel some shame on. Ala is a preposition on. Halak, if you know, hal means self. So be ashamed on yourself. Literally, it means be ashamed of yourself. That's how we create the perfect sentence. Shame on you. Istahi ala halak. Istahi ala halak. If you're a female and you have to be ashamed of yourself, what happens is istahi becomes istahi a little bit longer. And again, when we were talking in a dialect, it's not important how you write it because there is no right way to write it in Arabic. The important part is how you pronounce it. Istahi, longer E. Ala, on stays ala. What happens to halak, on yourself? It becomes halik. It's exactly like saying, how are you? Kif halak? Kif halik? Or what's your name? Shu ismak? Shu ismik? Etc. So the change is in the preposition, in the object pronoun. I think if you're a beginner, total beginner, you will find this explanation when it comes to grammar difficult. If you're not, then this is totally making sense. Because I'm not talking Chinese, I'm talking Arabic, which you already know in order to be at this level of speaking Palestinian Arabic. So istahi ala halik, be ashamed of you, you woman. Istahi ala halik. And if you're a lot of people and I want to tell you, shame on you, shame on you, and be ashamed of yourselves. Imagine we're saying selves, not self. So the verb istahi becomes istahu. We add u because all verbs in the past that you males are doing it, we end it with u. Istahu, you, all of you. Ala stays ala. What happens to hal? Hal becomes halku. Istahu ala halku. In some Palestinian dialect, this ku can end up with kum. So you might hear it istahu ala halkum. It's also acceptable. Istahi ala halak. Shame on you, man. Istahi ala halik. Shame on you, woman. Istahu ala halku. Shame on all of you, people. So this is a way to say shame on you. But I want also to take you from this and teach you one other way that is much, much more used and simpler, because it's only one word, three letters. Imagine all this. Istahi halak, istahi halik, istahi halko can be made with one and only word. Imagine. And this is much, much more used in the Arab world. Of course, not saying that this is not working. This does work, and this is a correct way to say "Istihya halak, shame on you." But I'm sure you have heard, if you're an Arab, or if you're you have like some Arab connections or Arab friends even, or origins, you have heard about this word. I loved teaching it today because it brought back some memories from my grandfather. This word is pronounced, there's a ayn, there's a ya, there's a b. This is the word aib. Three letters, very easy letters. We use this aib a lot. My father, my mother have told it, or have said this to me 1,000 times. I say it to my own child 1,000,000 times. What is this aib? Aib is very like well implanted in the Arab society, in the Arab culture, not only in the language. Aib, I will teach you literally, and I will tell you why we use it and why it, what it means. And why is it connected with the lesson of today, which is how to say shame on you. Now, aib, literally, it means a defect, something that is defect. This is a noun, actually. Defect, there's a defect. But we don't use it. If I tell you aib, I don't tell you defect. Doesn't mean anything. The literal meaning of the word is defect, and it's a noun. Now, how we use it, we don't use it as a noun. We use it as a verb, we use it as an adjective, we use it as a noun, we use it as everything in grammar, if you wish. But what is the meaning of when I say somebody is defect? So the original meaning is of aib is defect, but aib means this is defectful, this is shameful, this is wrong. This is, you're doing something that is not right. Absolutely. It has a connection with haram. You might see, you might tell me, okay, but this is also similar to haram. No. Haram is something that is forbidden to be done. That you shouldn't do. It's haram. Aib, it's something that you would do. But if you do it, it's a shame that you did it. You have to be ashamed of doing it. Now, why is aib so much used? Because we use it in, for everything. You, like a person came and told me marhaba ya maha or marhaba ya jama'a. I didn't answer him. That's aib. My mom would tell me aib. Shame on you. So you see, it's like an adjective or a verb. Sorry. Shame on you. It's a shame. It's a aib to not answer somebody who tells you salamu alaykum or marhaba. Aib. If you're showing too much skin, aib. Aib. If you're acting weird in front of public, aib. This is aib. So aib, it also means you have to be ashamed of yourself. But literally, it's the noun. It's shameful and it's not right to be done. Not it's forbidden, but it's shameful and embarrassing. But let me add some more things to aib and do some sentences so you can understand why we use it this much. Aib can be also like istihi, be ashamed, istihya halak, be ashamed of yourself. Also, aib can be added to another or something else can be added to aib to complete the whole sense. Aib, alik. Aib, alik. Now, I'm sure you know that this ala, ala means on. Or if you don't know, ala, it's just simply a preposition that means on. Ek, at the ending, it's you. So on you. This k at the ending, it's you. Aib alik. Shame on you. Defect on you. Aib alik. Shame on you. Aib alik. If you're a female, aib aliki. We only change this ending. Aib aleki. Shame on you, female. Aib aleki. Aib aleko or aleikum. If you remember, you change this into ko. Aib alek. Aib aleki. Aib aleko. All of you. Now, I told you we hear it a lot. We have it a lot in the Arab world because, like, let's imagine my mom and dad were invited into an Arab wedding. And they are contemplating or thinking not to go. If my mom would say, I don't want to go. And this happens, you know, in the daily life, it happens. My mom says, I don't want to go. My dad would say, La, aib. Aib man ruhish. It's aib. So with simply aib, without him saying, so here, aib alayki, shame on you. Because there's nothing to be ashamed of, you know, her in particular, aib alayki. No, it's aib. Using it as a noun, it's a shame or it's really shameful not to go. Aib is repeated a lot. Aib, for example,
ما نروح ما نروح ما not to go عيب ما نروح ما نروح or ما نروحش this ish is optional
this negates the verb نروح which means to go so my mom بديش أروح I don't want to go my dad would tell her
عيب عيب ما نروحش it's عيب not to go
عيب is used by me as I told you to tell my daughter to not do anything like in one day in my life even in Italy I use the word عيب 1,000 times
عيب تاكلي بإيديكي
عيب تاكلي you eat بإيديكي with your hands
it's also عيب you see a lot of things are عيب it's not that I'm meaning it's shameful.
Remember, I'm giving you situations where you would use these words and I'm trying to explain to you that they are not translated exactly and literally to English or any other language. These are used in a lot of situations where it's not forbidden, but it's something that is a little bit shameful to do. Less than shameful, less than
عيب عليكي, shame on you, literally.
When you use عيب as a noun, it's simply not okay. It's shameful. It's not okay. So عيب تاكلي بإيدك.
I would tell my daughter عيب تاكلي. You eat. That's تاكلي. بإيدك. بإيدك with your hand.
Remember, this is a Palestinian dialect. Lesson. What I'm writing here is only in the spoken language and that's not a correct Arabic in the MSA. That's exactly what you would say speaking. In Arabic here, written like this, it's not a correct Arabic language. It's only the way we would say things in the spoken language. So,
عيب تاكلي بإيدك, remember عيب?
عيب تحكي بصوت عالي.
تحكي, let's see. عيب تحكي. You speak ب صوت عالي.
عيب تحكي بصوت عالي.
It's a shame. It's shameful. It's wrong. It's not correct. To تحكي بصوت عالي.
To speak with a loud voice.
صوت voice عالي loud or high.
تحكي you speak. So this is how we would create sentences with عيب. As I told you, عيب is implanted in all of our culture. Everything we do is عيب. Why? And why like a lot of things end up being عيب in the Arab world? Because we are a very traditional and like we respect what others say about us. All of our actions for us are calculated perfectly so we don't harm or hurt others or that we don't or that are not seen by others as harmful or shameful. And that's why a lot of our daily situations would be described as عيب, even though it's not shameful or عيب in other cultures. That's what I'm trying to tell you. One funny thing that I told my students this morning that I'm teaching here, this is exactly where I teach with my whiteboard and I have the computer and their faces are in front of me. And I have, I'm in my studio and I have a lot of pictures here from my childhood. And I have a picture of my late grandfather. And I remembered while I was teaching them this عيب, I remembered him, my grandfather, one day he was like a very heavy man, obese, very fun. It was so much fun to sit and listen to his stories. One day he drank a lot. He drank a lot of عرق. عرق is our favorite anise-based alcohol. And it's very, very strong. And one day I remember he was at our house sitting on the couch, like him on with all his, like, you know, he was very big. In size, and he got drunk. I remember when he got drunk, he spent 2 or 3 hours saying عيب, عيب. I used to say this word عيب 1,000 times in these 3 hours, and we couldn't stop laughing. I really regret we don't have like some video of him being in this state, heavy, sitting on the couch, drunk, and saying عيب. He was what he was saying. He was telling us a story, and then he said عيب. It's عيب that story. But then he continued saying عيب for his own situation. It's عيب that he's drunk and he's in this situation, and he kept on saying عيب for like hours to come. And I remembered that during the lesson, and my students were laughing so hard. So I like to put my students in situational Arabic, you know, because I'm not your typical Arabic teacher. I think you know already from YouTube. I like also to teach you some of the spoken language, not only the standard Arabic, because this is what you need in order to communicate, to get to know the culture, knowing the language. So if I teach you only boring grammar, you will not understand. I want to put you in situations where you would use عيب. Remember, عيب is used a lot. Everything, almost everything, you speak loud, you eat with your hands, don't talk to me like this, it's عيب. And when you want to emphasize somebody who really, like in your culture, somebody does something wrong, which is counted as wrong in your culture, then it's then when you use استحيا حالك, like the real and direct shame on you, or عيب عليك, literally shame on you, or this shame or this wrong or this defect عليك on you. While if you're just talking about simple things during the daily life that happen a lot in the Arab world and end up being shameful, use simply the noun عيب without any conjugation at all. Just simply say عيب, and you will, usually you will not say عيب to somebody else, but you will hear the word عيب said by Arabs, because what's عيب for the Arabs is not عيب for you. But anyways, this is a lesson in the spoken dialect of how to say shame on you, or shame, or shameful in general. I hope you liked it. If you liked it, make sure you subscribe to this channel. I'm going to bring a lot of spoken or a lot of situational Arabic sentences, maybe with more examples, because with عيب it was so difficult for me to portray the meaning. It's something that is not translatable in other languages. But I hope that these situations that I brought from my culture to you, talking about my grandfather and عيب, and the mom, when I talk to my daughter, I tell her عيب, or my parents refusing an invitation and my dad saying, but it's عيب. I hope these help put you in a situation of where and when to use these new words and expressions that I'm teaching you. And remember, I opened also the possibility to become an exclusive member of the channel, where you have access to only exclusive content and mainly live streams. Once a month I will hold a live stream in which I can speak or talk or chat to you or answer your questions or answer whatever request from you regarding topics that I don't usually discuss in my lessons. And if you are also interested in joining one of my online courses are going to end up on May 1st, but I'm going to open new classes from May 1st and on. So make sure, I will write you also the link below so you can go and attend one of my online classes. And yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching. Shukran. And عيب عليكم if you didn't watch it. And I'll see you in the following Arabic Palestinian lesson with me, Maha. مع السلامة. Bye.